anti-theista shows no signs of dying down in the national capital. Protesters, including students from Jamia Millia Islamia University and JNU, converged at Delhi Police's ITO headquarters last night to hold demonstrations against the contentious law. In the all-night protest, the students braved the winter chill to demand the release of those detained in anti-CA protests in Delhi. Protests are also scheduled at Jantar Mantar today at 3 p.m. Meanwhile, Bhim Army Chief Chandrasekhar Azad, who was arrested for Friday's violence in Old Delhi, has been sent to 14-day judicial custody. India Today has also accessed video footage of Friday's violence in Delhi's Simapuri. In the footage, agitators can be seen charging towards policemen and attacking them. 11 accused in Simapuri violence were yesterday sent to 14-day judicial custody.
Surrounding the protests all over the country over the issue of CAA and NRC, we are right now outside the Delhi Police Headquarters, where students from different universities, students from different colleges have actually started gathering here. Some are from JNU, some are from Jamia, and some are from different walks of life. Their anger is against the police action which took place in the previous days regarding the action, regarding the lathi charge, regarding the detainment which actually police took for the protesters. It is chilling cold outside, and as we can see, there is no hurdle in the traffic movement. The traffic movement is very smooth. Plus, what we can see is, even on Friday, this protest right at this location took place, and even on Saturday, even on today, it is likely to be held till late in the night. Nikhil Lakhwani reporting for India Today, Delhi.
Meanwhile, protests still continue in the national capital, but no violence has been reported on Saturday, unlike Friday. Heavy security is in place across the capital, with over 1,000 personnel deployed in Seelampur area alone. This even as Bhim Army Chief, who was arrested for inciting violence in the Old Delhi area on Friday, has been sent to 14-day judicial custody.
Protest against the Citizenship Amendment Act shows no sign of ebbing in the national capital. Students at the Jamia Millia Islamia University continued their protest peacefully on Saturday against the contentious law.
There are peaceful protests that are happening inside the campus. There are students over here, there are former students over here, faculty members, locals of the Jamia area as well, who are of course gathered in large numbers, raising slogans, chanting against NRC and CAA, and of course carrying us as well. There's music over here as well, and the protests have been largely peaceful.
Lawyers too came out in support of the protesting students.
बेरोजगारी की बात होनी चाहिए आप बेरोजगारी का रजिस्ट्रेशन कराओ कि कितने इस मुल्क में पढ़े लिखे ग्रेजुएट पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट बेरोजगार हैं उनके लिए रोजगार का निजाम करो आप सारी चीजों को उलझाकर अर्थव्यवस्था महंगाई बेरोजगारी सबको गुमराह कर रहे हो और इस लड़ाई को हिंदू मुस्लिम का रंग दे रहे हो
वी आर नॉट अपोजिंग द एनआरसी बट द सीए वी आर अपोजिंग सीए बिकॉज़ इट्स डिस्क्रिमिनेट द पीपल Discriminated the people on the community basis.
We want the Supreme Court to declare the act as unconstitutional because it's completely arbitrary in nature. It's against the secular nature that has been put in our preamble and what has been put in the Constitution of India. It is against what has been taught to us in the 5 years of law that we have studied. We want them to take it down.
Students and activists also gathered at Rajghat, but unlike Friday, protests remained peaceful throughout Delhi. The police, however, remained at its toes. Around 1,000 personnel were deployed in Delhi's Seelampur area. Tight security arrangements were made in Old Delhi, which saw violence on Friday. Bhim Army Chief Chandrasekhar Azad, who was held yesterday, remains in custody.
ऐसे नेता को कम से कम बिना किसी वजह के जेल में नहीं भेजा जाना चाहिए ये सब बहस हमने की लेकिन इसके बाद भी माननीय न्यायालय ने उसको डिसमिस किया है खारिज किया उन्हें 14 दिन की रिमांड पे भेजा है और हम इसके लिए अपील करेंगे तुरंत
Fifteen people who were also arrested for Friday's violence at Daryaganj were sent to two-day judicial custody by the Tisazari court. In a separate hearing at Karkarduma Court, 11 people accused of violence in Delhi's Simapuri area on Friday were sent to 14-day judicial custody.
The protests against the CAA continue, even as Chandrasekhar Azad Ravan has given a statement to the media saying that he is being framed because he was just trying to protect the constitution. This is Anisha Mathur in New Delhi for India Today.
Meanwhile, amid nationwide unrest over the contentious Citizenship Amendment Act, Prime Minister Modi will be participating in a rally at Delhi's Ram Leela Maidan today at 11:30 a.m. At the rally, the Prime Minister will be sounding the poll bugle ahead of assembly elections in Delhi. PM Modi is also expected to speak on the contentious law, which has sparked protests all across the nation. The venue for the rally happens to be a little over a kilometer from Daryaganj, which was hit by violent anti-CA protests on Friday. It is being estimated that over 2 lakh people will be gathering to listen to PM Modi. During the rally, the Prime Minister will also be thanked for granting ownership rights to 40 lakh people living in unauthorized colonies in Delhi. The Delhi police, meanwhile, has made tight security arrangements with thousands of police personnel deployed at the rally venue. This after intelligence reports suggested possible attempt by Pak-based terrorists to target PM Modi at the rally.
कल जो रैली है वो बहुत विशाल होगी और रैली ऐसे समय के अंदर हो रही है जब चुनाव भी बहुत नजदीक हैं तो आप इसको चुनाव की शंखनाद भी समझ सकते हैं एक तरह से भारतीय जनता पार्टी की ओर से इसी रैली के अंदर जो 11 लाख हस्ताक्षर कराए गए हैं अनाधिकृत कॉलोनियों में जिनको आप देख रहे हैं यहां पर रखे हुए हैं वो प्रधानमंत्री को भेंट किए जाएंगे
Uttar Pradesh remains on edge over Anti-Citizenship Amendment Act protests. Yesterday, also fresh violence witnessed in several parts of the state. 15 people were killed in violence across the state. However, the police have denied firing any bullets. UP Police Top Brass says that 265 Uttar Pradesh cops were injured in the violence since Thursday. Out of them, 57 cops have suffered from firearm injuries. UP government has also launched a massive crackdown on protesters. In total, FIR has been filed against 10,000 people. Cops have arrested 102 for objectionable posts on social media. Cops claim that more than 6 people who have been arrested in Lucknow for violence hail from Malda and West Bengal. Today, a TMC delegation is likely to visit Lucknow to meet the families of those deceased. UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath has once again appealed for calm.
Uttar Pradesh is on the edge. The protests against the Citizenship Amendment Act continue to cinch the state. Fresh violence was witnessed in Rampur, where one person died, pushing the death toll above 10. In Kanpur, a police post was set on fire. On Friday, police and protesters fought pitched battles across several cities in Uttar Pradesh. Protesters defied the statewide prohibitory orders, pelted stones, vandalized public property, and set buses, cars, motorcycles on fire, throwing life out of gear. Cracking down on the violence, UP police has filed FIR against 10,000 people. Among those arrested is a sitting SP MLA and a former SP MLA. UP top cop says that outsiders, some politicians and NGOs could be instigating the violence.
हम सभी एंगल्स की जांच कर रहे हैं और देख रहे हैं कि कौन-कौन उसमें तत्व शामिल थे उसमें एनजीओस भी शामिल हो सकते हैं पॉलिटिकल पर्सनल भी शामिल हो सकते हैं और बाहरी तत्व भी शामिल हो सकते हैं
Backing his claim, cops arrested 6 men hailing from Malda in West Bengal.
6 लोग हमने अरेस्ट किए वो मूल रूप से मालदा के रहने वाले हैं हालांकि उनका कहना है कि यहां पर वो मुर्गा मंडी में व्यवसाय करते थे छोटा-मोटा अपना लेकिन उनके बयानों से आगे के लिंक्स हम लोग कनेक्ट कर रहे हैं
A TMC delegation is likely to visit Lucknow on Sunday to meet families of those who died during protests Earlier UP CM Yogi Adityanath had vowed to auction properties of those involved in vandalism
इस हिंसा में लिप्त प्रत्येक तत्व की प्रॉपर्टी को जब्त करेंगे और उस जब्त से सार्वजनिक संपत्ति को हुए नुकसान या कहीं पर पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी को जो डैमेज किया गया है इसकी भरपाई भी हम उन सभी उपद्रवियों से करेंगे क्योंकि वे सब चिन्हित चेहरे हैं वे सब वीडियोग्राफी में आ चुके हैं सीसीटीवी के फुटेज में आ चुके हैं।
Amid violent protest and heavy unrest in entire Uttar Pradesh, police started its investigation. They are trying to identify people through CCTV footage and pictures taken from various newspapers. Now this is a big question whether this is protest on the basis of emotions and they came out on the roads or it's a part of larger conspiracy. With camera person Harish Kanpal and Nilanshu Shukla, this is Shivan Srivastava for India Today in Lucknow.
Over to Bihar, where anti-CAA protests erupted across the state. While the RJD called for a Bihar Bandh, the Janata Dal United demanded an urgent NDA meeting to discuss the current political situation. Here's a report.
The anti-citizenship stir has spread to Bihar with protests in more than 10 cities across the state on Saturday. The Rashtriya Janata Dal called for a Bihar Bandh in protest against the new law, with RJD leader Tejaswi Yadav leading a massive rally in Patna.
RJD ke Bihar Bandh mein ab Tejaswi Yadav shamil ho chuke hain, sarkon par utre hain. Filhal aap tasveerein dekh sakte hain. Tejaswi RJD karyalay se paidal march karte hue yahan nikal rahe hain aur Dak Bangla चौराहा तक जो है ये प्रदर्शन यहाँ चलेगा।
In Patna, RJD workers burned tires and raised slogans against the Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar and Modi government. Protesters also broke barricades and blocked the roads. In Darbhanga, RJD supporters protested on railway tracks and disrupted train movements. Demonstrations also took place at Begusarai, Nawada, Motihari and Ara. As protests raged on Friday, Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar broke his silence, saying that NRC would not be implemented in the state, even though JDU supported the citizenship bill in the both houses of the parliament earlier this month, leading the opposition RJD to accuse CM Nitish Kumar of hypocrisy.
उनके कहने से थोड़ी दोहरी नीति नहीं चलेगी। एक तरफ आप पास करवा रहे हैं, दूसरी तरफ कह रहे हैं कि एनआरसी नहीं लागू होगा। लोगों को ठगना बंद करें नीतीश कुमार जी, अब बहुत हो गया।
जेडीयू एंड द बीजेपी हैव हिट बैक एट द आरजेडी अक्यूजिंग देम ऑफ ऑर्केस्ट्रेटिंग वायलेंस इन द स्टेट।
बंद में ये लोग उपद्रव करते हैं, सरकारी संपत्ति को नष्ट करना, रोड पर नंगा नाच करना। राष्ट्रीय जनता दल का चाल चेहरा चरित्र जो है आज सामने आ चुका है।
कांग्रेस के सहयोगी दल आरजेडी द्वारा इस बंद और हिंसा के दौरान आगजनी जैसे विषयों का प्रयोग किया गया। क्या कांग्रेस देश में आगजनी का उपद्रव का समर्थन करती है?
जेडीयू इज द फर्स्ट अलायंस पार्टनर टू हैव रेज कंसर्न ओवर द प्रेजेंट पॉलिटिकल सिचुएशन प्रिवेलिंग इन द कंट्री एंड हैज डिमांडेड कॉलिंग अ मीटिंग ऑफ द एनडीए टू डिस्कस द इशू। And with Nitish Kumar already declaring that NRC will not be implemented in Bihar is enough to keep the BJP on the tenterhook. This is Rohit Singh in Patna for India Today.
2 days after anti-CAA protest claimed the life of 23-year-old Nausheen, India Today visited the grieving family. Nausheen's brother said that Nausheen left for work as usual on 19th morning. He worked as a welder. His boss left him earlier on that day due to violent protests across the city. On his way back home, the police shot at Nausheen on his back and left him to die. It was Nausheen's friend that took him to the hospital. His family has claimed that Nausheen had nothing to do with the protests. They've also questioned the Mangaluru police's action as to why did they have to fire bullets on innocent protesters. They've also demanded strict action against the police commissioner. On 19th December, two protesters died in a police firing during protests in Mangaluru. The other victim, 49-year-old Jaleel, also suffered bullet injuries.
थोड़ा जल्दी आया, उसको ओनर बोला, ऐसे उधर थोड़ा लफड़ा हो रहा है, ऐसे इसलिए वो इधर आने के लिए आने के टाइम उधर ऐसा पुलिस लोग ऐसे गोली मारा, वो थोड़ा उधर ज़्यादा क्या लफड़ा हो रहा था, सिर्फ बाद में इधर आए, इधर आने के लिए सोचा, उसको गोली मारा पुलिस लोग कम। वही मैंगलोर पुलिस कमिश्नर है, वही ऑर्डर देने को वाला है, वही है ना। हाँ, वही वही को मैं हम लोग न्याय चाहिए, उतनी ही सजा सजा होना पड़ेगा उसको कमिश्नर को।
as nationwide protests continue over the Citizenship Amendment Act, we speak to some of the protesters as to how much do they really know about what are they protesting for. Let's listen in.
मुस्लिम लोगों को यहाँ से इंडिया से बाहर निकालने का
किसने बोला? कौन ऐसा बोला कि मुस्लिम लोगों को इंडिया से बाहर?
सत्ता वाले बोल रहे
हैं मुसलमान को इसमें लिस्ट से बाहर निकाला जा रहा है।
इस लिस्ट से
एक नया बिल जो अमित शाह लागू किए अभी।
कौन सा बिल?
एससीपी ऐसा कुछ है।
आप इस प्रोटेस्ट में शामिल हुए हैं, किस कारण से शामिल हुए हैं?
जो मुसलमानों को भगाया जा रहा है, जो बिल है।
किसको भगाया गया
अभी तक? वो जो बिल चल रहा है।
पहला सवाल आपने कहा मुसलमानों को भगा रहे, किसको भगाया?
खुला है, बोल रहे हैं कि जिनका आधार कार्ड या पैन कार्ड जो
बोला है सर, कहाँ सुना आपने सर?
बिल में
किस चीज़ का विरोध कर रहे हैं आप लोग?
हम लोग अट्ठू का विरोध कर रहे हैं, एनआरसी का।
एनआरसी है क्या ये?
एनआरसी जो प्रधान जी से पूछे, एनआरसी क्या है प्रधान जी बताइए आप।
यहाँ पर धरना प्रदर्शन जो हो रहा है महंगाई के खिलाफ, किसान के धान जो है बर्बाद हो रहा है, एनआरसी।
और किस किस चीज़ का विरोध हो रहा है
यहाँ पे? एनआरसी का विरोध हो रहा है। एनआरसी के बारे में ही जानकारी है कि जो नागरिकता, इसके पास जमीन नहीं रहेगी वो कहाँ से नागरिकता लाएगा?
ये क्या करने आए हैं आप यहाँ पे?
महंगाई के खिलाफ, एनआरसी, यही सब।
आप लोग विरोध प्रदर्शन करने आए हैं?
हाँ जी।
तो ये आपको पता है एनआरसी क्या है?
अब ये तो पता नहीं है।
एक ही आपको फुल फॉर्म मालूम है
जी?
क्या है?
CAA कन्वर्शन असेंबली बिल।
एनआरसी की पूरी फॉर्म आती है आपको?
नेशनल
आप समाजवादी पार्टी के इतने बड़े नेता हो, आप यहाँ धरना प्रदर्शन कर रहे हो, आपको CAA का मतलब भी नहीं मालूम
जी? नागरिक संघ
क्या आपको ये लगता है? ये ज्ञान की कमी है समाजवादी पार्टी में?
ज्ञान की कमी कहीं नहीं है, लेकिन सरकार जो कर रही है वो गलत है।
क्या है एनआरसी बारे में कोई जानकारी है आपको?
अरे नेशनल रजिस्ट्रेशन सर्टिफिकेट जो बनाया जा रहा है, जो लोगों के तीन पुस्त के पहले से जो कानून के बारे में जो मांगा जा रहा है, जो उनसे तथ्य मांगे जा रहे हैं।
फॉर एवरी मोमेंट दैट हैज सीन वायलेंस देयर हैज बीन अ काइंड जेस्चर, अ हार्टवार्मिंग मोमेंट दैट हैज जस्ट टच्ड द लाइफ ऑफ समवन आउट देयर, बी इट अ प्रोटेस्टर और अ कॉप। इन आवर सीरीज इंडिया अबव हेट, वी ब्रिंग यू सच स्टोरीज एवरी डे टू फोकस ऑन द गुड एंड द ह्यूमेन। टेक अ लुक।
Protests against the contentious citizenship law have been largely chaotic and violent at times. But there have been moments of reason that give hope. Protesters outside Jamia Millia Islamia serve tea to the police personnel present there. Not just in Delhi, in Uttar Pradesh's Lakhimpur area, as police carried out a flag march, an imam from a nearby masjid offered refreshments to the khaki clad.
ये भी हमारे एक समाज के अंग हैं, इसलिए हमने इनको चाय पिलाई है। हमने पूरा पूरा पैगाम दिया है कि सलामती के साथ किसी को अजियत ना पहुंचाएं, तकलीफ ना पहुंचाएं।
अभी एनआरसी पूरे देश में लागू होने की कोई बात लिखा पड़ी में कहीं।
The DM of Basti district went out on the streets to educate the public about the Citizenship Act and NRC. He hugged people from the Muslim community and clicked pictures with them. After protest erupted in Kanpur, residents formed a human chain and appealed for peace by offering roses to police personnel. In the national capital, a solidarity group reached Daryaganj police station to help the detainees who were not part of any violent protests.
Our only objective is that those who've not done anything, those who've just been picked up, because we know that there have been some who were picked up, they were eating there. I mean, they were eating dinner. There was a boy who was selling water. So those who haven't done anything, they should be released as soon as possible. And there should be no charges against those who are innocent.
The spirit of unity in these times of anger proved that India can rise above hate. Bureau Report, India Today.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.